Hi viewer, I welcome you to Edim TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through Geography Form 2, lesson number 18. The topic it is internal land forming processes. I'm your tutor, Lucy Methoni. Welcome. Let us look at our objectives. By the end of the lesson, the learner should be able to explain all the features that result from the volcanicity, those that are extrusive. And for the extrusive that we are going to look at today, it is those that result from the fissure eruption. Remember we said, there are those that will result from the fissure eruption and others through the vent. So today we are looking at those features that result from the fissure eruption. We start. Fissure eruption occurs through fissures or cracks as a result of large vents through which magma reaches the surface, lava spread over large areas forming plateaus. So you can see when it comes through out through the fissures, through the cracks, it will spread over a large area forming plateaus. In Kenya, we have plateaus like Yatia, we also have Lake Ipia. We have Uasin Gishu, or these are plateaus, and they were formed by the when the magma erupted through the fissure. There are two types of features resulting from the fissure eruption. That is lava plateau and tuff plateau. Let us have a look at them. Now, when we talk about the lava plateau, it is formed when lava escapes through different fissures and spread over a wide area. So in this case, now you get that you have a number of fissures, small cracks. So it will spread over a wide area. The lava has low viscosity, which makes it very fluid and hence flows over long distance on gentle slopes before cooling and solidifying. That is the reason as to why it will make a plateau. The rock build up unevenly instead of piling around a single vent. That is the reason why we get a plateau and not a volcano. The resultant landform is relatively even surface with very gentle slopes. The lava fills former valleys and covers most of the landscape with the exception of high hills. Lava plateaus are often quite fertile areas. That is the reason why you look at these areas, especially Uasin Gishu. It is very fertile. We have a lot of agricultural activity being carried in these areas since it is very fertile. This is how the nature of lava plateaus look like. You can be able to see it is extensive and it is large. These soils are very fertile. They allow even mechanization. That is the reason as to why maize growing is favored in Uasin Gishu. We look at the next feature, that is the tuff plateaus. These are wide areas of flat land similar to lava plateau that forms the eruption of volcanic rock referred to as the tuff. So this one, now there is a rock that is being formed. Tuff does not flow quietly out of the ground like lava. It is produced in violent explosion which draws shattered fragment I in the air, resulting to the formation of these rocks. These fragments cools and added as they fry in the air. They even eventually fall back on the ground further away from the point of eruption, depending on their weight. On falling on the ground, they form volcanic rocks, particles called the pyroclast or tephra. Examples of these tephra, we have volcanic ash, we also have lapilli, we also have blocks, the pumice, the one that I've given this example. We also have the activity for today. Explain how love of prayer too is formed. That is the first question. Reference, you can visit the KRB 2003 Secondary Geography Student Book 2, that edition. If at all you want to get us, you can get us either you SMS us, you can also get us through the YouTube, you can get us through the Facebook, and also you can Twitter us. Stay tuned to Edim TV. Thank you.